Hello and welcome to the Labtics installation environment. We use it at labdo.org to install educational software on donated laptops. Today I'm going to show you our two-click installer, Labdo Image Installer, and it's very easy. Just open Space.fm, our file manager in this environment. You will see here SDB, an external USB disk drive. It is not mounted, so it's a minus in front. Just clicking on it will change it to a plus. Now it is mounted and the computer can use it. And you will see here the matching images which can be installed. You have to choose if you have a 32-bit or 64-bit. You will see it here on top. It is a 32-bit CPU in my example. And also you can select various languages like English, Spanish or French. Then the content in these languages is also pre-configured, and you have various images matching with your disk size. I select the first one here, just the right mouse click on the image, and you will see here Labdo Image Installer. And if you click on that, next is you have just two options. Do you want to shred the disk drive or not? Very few information, and you can also change the host name if you already know it. That's all. This option shred is to remove former user data from the disk. It's really recommended to do so because we promise it to all our donors. In this example, I'm skipping it just to save some time. If you need more option or more functionality, please refer to the Labdo installer or auto-deploy. Those tools are coming with much more options. Now when you start, it will continue to copy the image data to the local disk drive. Depending on your computer and the size of the image, it might last up to 1 or 2 hours. In this case, it will just take a few minutes. I'll be back to you in a few minutes to go through the final steps of the installation process. See you. So back again, the installation process came more or less to an end. Will count up to 100%, and at the end the boot information, grub information will be saved and the file system will be checked, and then a new window will open, the partition manager and the size of the partition will automatically be adapted to the size of your disk drive, and that's the end of the installation process. Once you see the partition manager and that the complete disk size is used, then you can shut down the system. So that is what I meant. Here this part of the disk is used. This is the complete size of the disk being available for the user, and you can either close the windows or you can shut down the system. Thank you.